Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our presentation of enhancing communication by using pictography. In the first place, I must say that this idea will not be here to replace the oral marine communication. To execute this idea, we have came up with our main question, which goes as follows. How can pictography be used to improve internship communication? Now, to answer this question, you will have to look to the problem itself. So therefore, we have our problem definition and our problem description. Our problem definition goes as follows. Communication between vessels and coastal stations is inefficient and can be improved by using pictography. Then we have our problem description, which in the first place we have the language barriers. This is mostly one of the main causes of misunderstanding and accidents in the maritime industry. In the second place, we have the pronunciation issues, which is also related to the ethnicity of a person. Seeing that we work with a very diverse ethnicity crew members, so you have different pronunciations of the English language. In the third place, we have the lack of training. Most people go through training, but mostly not on a level that is needed to speak the English language properly. And all these three issues can endanger the safety of the vessel and the crew. To answer our main question, we have to look at every aspect of the main question itself. So we have to look at the sub-questions of what forms of maritime communications are there. Why using pictograms to enhance communication and to support oral communication? How are the standard marine communication phrases going to be translated into pictures? What are the requirements regarding clarity, safety and efficiency for the pictograms? How can pictograms be transmitted? The current situation of communication is verbally transmitted to VHF, HF and MF radio frequency, and the non-verbal communication through digital selective calling. This is a pretty stable platform, but it still has its flaws. And to help reduce the risk of accidents, we have came up with the idea to transmit pictograms through the AIS system. Why using pictograms to enhance communication and to support oral communication? The advantages of this system is that you will break any language barrier that exists in the communication. By transmitting these pictograms, you could always double check if the information that you got through the VHF radio is correctly. You could also reduce the noisy VHF communication that mostly comes in the channel areas or traffic separation seam areas. By using these pictograms, you could always check what the intentions of a ship in your vicinity is without having to communicate through the VHF radio. This system also has its disadvantages. The transmission of these pictograms will be done through the AIS systems, which works on the VHF, and this means that you have to be in the range of VHF range to transmit a pictogram, which is a range of about 40 nautical miles. How are the standard marine communication phrases going to be translated? For the translation of the standard marine communication phrases, we have chosen to only translate the intership communication phrases. These are the phrases that, these are the ship-to-ship communication and ship-to-shore communication. So we will for sure focus on the distress, urgency and safety phrases. There's also a number of pictograms that are not covered by the phrases, which are the traffic situations and the maneuvering phrases. These pictograms will have to be pretty clear and easy to understand for everybody. So the colors of these pictograms will have to be clearly distinguishable from each other and from the other colors on the ECDIS display. One way to make the message stand out on the ECDIS display is by using a flashing exclamation mark above the vessel that is transmitting a pictogram. The size of these pictograms will not be fixed, seeing that every vessel has a different size ECDIS display. So for the sake of clarity, it will be able to zoom in and out to see all the information on the pictograms. So this also means that these pictograms will have to be made in high definition so that they can stay sharp at any zoom level. Concepts. Our first concept is a ship-shaped figure with a green color on its starboard side and a red color on its port side. And in this situation, we have an overtaking vessel, which you can see by the arrow. This is our second concept, which is also based on the same purpose. And the only difference here is that it's an arrow-shaped figure instead of a ship-shaped figure with the same colors on the port and the starboard side. And this was our third concept, which is look-alike of the first one. Last, we have chosen to use our second concept, which is the arrow-shaped figure, because it has the clearer style and it can contain more information than all the other concepts. On this PowerPoint, you can see in the first picture a vessel that is restricted in its maneuverability. This pictogram has a green color on its starboard side and a red color on its port side. And in the white part of the pictogram, you could see the day mark of a vessel that is restricted in its maneuverability. In the second pictogram, you could also see a vessel that is engaged in trawling, with the day mark of a trawling vessel in the white part of the pictogram. And also, it has the light sign, which is green above white, on the top right corner of the pictogram. These pictograms also come with the standard AIS information, which is the name of the vessel, the MMSI number of the vessel, and the call sign of the vessel. This information comes at the bottom right corner of the pictogram. Distress and danger is good pictograms. In the first picture, you could see a pictogram of a man overboard. Since there is no symbol of a man overboard situation, we have created our own symbols. So in the top right corner, you could see a square with a red color and a yellow color in the middle splitting. And in the bottom right corner, you can also see the standard information that comes to the AIS system. In the second pictogram, the one in the middle, you could see a vessel that is under attack by pirates. And in the top right corner, you could see the symbol, which is a weapon, which symbolizes a piracy attack. And in the last one, you could see a vessel that is on fire, which also has a symbol of a flame. Maneuvering. In the first pictogram, you could see a vessel that is intending to inform the other that the starboard side is blocked and that the other vessel must pass in the port side. This is indicated through a cross on the starboard side of a vessel. In the second pictogram, you could see a vessel that is intending to inform the other vessels in its vicinity that he is trying to cross the traffic separation seam. And in the last pictogram, you could see a green to green pictogram, which is just an indication that the vessel is going to pass you on the starboard side. Here you can see an illustration of some of the compics that we have produced. We have produced about 40 compics, but there's still a lot of work to do. The transmission of the pictograms. You could have a pretty well designed pictogram, but if you can't transmit it, it's useless. So for the transmission of the pictograms, we have looked into two possibilities: transmitting to weather satellites and through AIS, which is automatic identification system. The weather satellites can send pictures from space to stations across the Earth by using an automatic picture transmitting program. This system sends data with information to a radio receiver and a decoder, and this picture will be decoded into a pictogram when it comes to its destination. But due to the long distance that this data has to travel, it can take up to 8 to 15 minutes to transmit a whole pictogram. So this is clearly not efficient in the maritime industry. So we have came up with our final solution, which is transmitting these pictograms to the AIS, which is Automatic Identification System. The AIS is intended to provide overview and information through interaction between vessels and authorities ashore. The idea is to send a code from station A to station B, which will be decoded in station B. Some dedicated software could be used to decode these codes into pictograms. And you could also connect the AIS system to the ECDIS display to help displaying these pictograms. And there's also enough code combination possible on the AIS system, so there will be enough codes for every pictogram. Now, here I will give an example of how this system could work. In this situation, the vessel Flinders Forest is intended to take the other vessel, which is Ambassador. Flinders Forest clicks on the overtake compic, and there were common red exclamation mark above the vessel that is transmitting this pictogram. Now the vessel Ambassador could click on the pictogram, and in the top right corner, you could see a compic tab on which you could click, and then the pictogram of overtaking vessel will appear. We have came back to our main question, which is how can pictography be used to improve intership communication? As conclusion, we can say that pictography can be used in every situation to improve intership communication, except when the distance between two vessels is bigger than the VHF range. We recommend that more research should be conducted about the possibility of integrating the pictograms into the ECDIS. About 30 pictograms have been made. As example, there should be a pictogram for every standard maritime communication phrase. Testing the idea about pictograms with a number of vessels would give a clearer answer about enhancing the safety for navigation. To realize this project, there should be more research done on the expenses of it. Thank you for your attention, and this was my presentation.